Hello everyone, happy afternoon, a very good afternoon. I hope and I believe all of you are doing well. Am I audible and visible? Yes, alright. So in the today's session, we are going to simplify the topic of antifungals, extremely important topic for your exam, be it the upcoming INICT, FMG or NEET exam. Generally, your INICT AIIMS exam has one question on this topic as well, antifungals, right? Yesterday, we had learned about partogram, and a partogram kiya tha kal in the 5 p.m. session. And very, very important, we have done your hepatitis B serology as well, right? So all these are very, very important topics. Okay, these are very, very important topics, and we had done the OBGY recall of INICT. Today also we have your sessions lined up like every day, like 5 p.m. and 10 p.m. 5 p.m. on the Unacademy app is what we are going to have the free live class. Today the target being ophthalmology, that is for your revision. So we'll try and revise important topics in ophthalmology. So squint is one area which we are focusing on, the pupil, the various pupillary abnormalities, squint, pupil, and if time permits, then your astigmatism, some questions on astigmatism as well. 10 p.m. we are going to have your session on Unacademy YouTube channel, where we will discuss the sutures, the previous year questions of sutures, because we discussed the mnemonics of sutures day before yesterday on the Unacademy app. Please watch that session before you come for this session, because it's going to be a rapid revision, and plus we are going to discuss the knots, okay, the sutures and knots in surgery. Okay, that's the plan for today. And today let us simplify this topic of antifungals. What are the potential questions that can come? Plus the most important, I'll be telling you tricks how to remember the various antifungal drugs. All right. Okay. So yes, Praveen, this video will be available later as well. You can watch this video later as well. Coming to first, the mechanism of action of the various group of antifungal drugs. Okay, what is the mechanism of action of the various antifungal drugs? So this is what is shown here. This is the fungal cell. We have the cell wall and we have the cell membrane, right? So remember, cell wall and cell membrane. So you can see that these beta glucans are present in the cell wall. Okay, this is cell wall, and under aapka cell membrane ka bilayer is there. Okay, now what is happening here, which drug is acting where? Your amphotericin B, nystatin, these basically come under your classification of the group of polyenes. Okay. Okay, it goes through the polyenes ka group mein aata hai, your amphotericin and nystatin. So as the term says, polyenes, amphotericin, you can write it as amphotericin. So that tells you this is polyene and it forms pores. So remember, very, very important, which drug acts by forming pores? One is amphotericin B, you have nystatin, and you have hermicin as well. ठीक है, ये बनाते हैं पोर्स इन द सेल मेम्ब्रेन. दे फॉर्म द पोर्स. बिकॉज ऑफ दैट व्हाट हैपेंस, ऑल द पोटेशियम फ्रॉम द फंगल सेल, ऑल द इंट्रासेल्युलर कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स गो आउट एंड द फंगस डाइज. सो इज इट अ साइडल ड्रग और इज इट अ स्टैटिक ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रग? पॉलीइन्स आर साइडल्स. ओके, दीज आर फंगीसाइडल्स. देन यू हैव द नेक्स्ट ग्रुप विच इज देयर, योर ग्लूकान सिंथेसिस, जो आपका सेल वॉल में बीटा ग्लूकान सिंथेसिस को इनहिबिट कर रहा है. So remember, echinocandins, they inhibit your glucan. So beta glucan synthesis is by your echinocandins. That is how you remember. So glucan is echinocandins. So you, what comes in your candins? The fungin wala drugs. Anidula fungin, mica fungin, caspofungin, all these are your candins, echinocandins. So remember, fungin wale drugs are echinocandins. Then you have azoles, which can be imidazoles, which can be triazoles. Now azoles and your terbinafin, how do they act? So you have a component which is very, very unique to fungi, which is ergosterol, which is not present in other organisms. That is why these drugs specifically kill the fungus only. They do not kill bacteria or anything. So these are not antibacterial because they are targeting ergosterol. Now for making ergosterol, first is squalene. From squalene, we get your lanosterol and then we get your ergosterol. So the step is basically SLE. Remember it as SLE. So you have squalene forming lanosterol. It that forms your ergosterol. So squalene pe act karne wala enzyme squalene epoxidase. So this is squalene epoxidase is inhibited by terbinafin. You can get match the following question on one column telling you the drugs and other column telling you the mechanism of action. So in antifungals, the most important is to know which drug acts by which mechanism of action. Very, very important. So remember terbinafin, T and S. If you say alphabetically, P, Q, R, S and T. So squalene epoxidase is inhibited by terbinafin. It is inhibiting formation of lanosterol basically. And then lanosterol to ergosterol, where you have your 14-D-methylase enzyme, that is inhibited by azoles. So azoles, they come at the end, they inhibit your ergosterol. Okay, so you can write azoles as ezoles. They are inhibiting ergosterol synthesis by inhibiting your 14-alpha-D-methylase enzyme. So humne main group jo aapke dekh liye drugs ke, amphotericin, azoles, terbinafin, echinocandins, and you have flucytosine. Again, the trick to remember here, cytosine, like we have read in our anti-cancer drugs. I hope all of you have watched those sessions. I have taken on Unacademy Plus. So, okay, PSM ke cohort studies, Methil is asking, we'll do it sometime. Anti-cancer drugs mein jab hum bolte hain the anti-metabolite group of anti-cancer drugs. How do we recognize? I've told you the trick. Like your 5-fluorouracil. Uracil, it is required in your DNA. Aapka jahan lagta hai, the basis, that is what will be your anti-metabolites. So your cytarabin, you have cytosine ka cyta. These are your anti-metabolite drugs. Similarly here, flucytosine. So cytosine required for DNA. So flucytosine inhibits your DNA-RNA synthesis. Okay, it is inhibiting your DNA-RNA synthesis. So that is about these drugs. Ek aur image dekh lete hain. Some extra drugs to be learnt here. So you have the nucleus. Then you have the ribosome. Okay, this is important. Extra edge point. Ribosome, where you have your protein synthesis which goes on. The drug which inhibits protein synthesis is your tavaborol. Okay, remember tavaborol. Easy to remember, T for T yaad rakhna. It inhibits your tRNA and that is how it inhibits your protein synthesis. T for T, this is the drug used topically for dermatophytosis. This is the drug used topically for dermatophytosis. Which is the drug which acts on mitotic spindle? So you have the mitotic spindle, which is important for the cell division to go on. The mitotic spindle pe act karne wala is greasyofulvin. So remember this as spindle moves like a grease. Very smoothly the spindle moves like a grease and allows the cell division. So grease is your greasyofulvin. It acts on mitotic spindle. DNA synthesis, we already saw flucytosine. Remember cyclopirox as well. Okay, cyclopirox, if they ask you, it is again an agent which inhibits your DNA synthesis. Cyclopirox. So kaise aapka ye DNA aise cyclic molecule hota hai, helical cyclic molecule, usme lagta hai pyrimidine, cyclopirox. So remember, it is like a cyclic molecule and pyrimidine, it inhibits your DNA synthesis. Cell wall and plasma membrane. Echinocandins act on the cell wall because beta glucan, echinocandin humne dekha, they inhibit your beta glucan synthesis in the cell wall. Polyenes, they form the pores in the plasma membrane, not in the cell wall, andar ka membrane mein they form the pores. So you have amphotericin B, nystatin and hermicin which come in this group. What is tolneftate? Another drug, which antifungal drug acts by causing hyphal distortion? That is your tolneftate. So remember, tolneftate tod deta hai aapka hyphae. So hyphae distortion kar raha hai. Todna, distortion, hyphal distortion. Then you have endoplasmic reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum is where your ergosterol is getting synthesized. Ergosterol synthesis SLE, so squalene to lanosterol, terbinafin, lanosterol to your ergosterol is azoles. So you have squalene epoxidase inhibitors, that is terbinafin, and you have imidazoles and triazoles, which basically come under azoles, and they inhibit conversion of lanosterol to ergosterol. Okay, everyone clear so far with this, the mechanism of action? Extra wale jo hai yahan pe, remember tavaborol, greaseofulvin, cycloperox, tolneftate, okay, and ergosterol synthesis is basically your endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, these are the points to be remembered. Now let us see the next one here. Now we have read that jab hum cryptococcal meningitis wagera mein, we give amphotericin B and we give flucytosine. Amphotericin B with flucytosine. The reason of giving amphotericin B along with flucytosine is, how is your flucytosine acting? What is the mechanism of action of flucytosine? Flucytosine inhibits your nucleic acid synthesis. So what it does is basically through the cytosine permease, it goes inside the cell. So this going inside the cell is enhanced by amphotericin because it is forming the pores. So amphotericin forms the pores and increases the penetration of 5-flucytosine. So it increases the cell permeability and allows flucytosine to penetrate the cell, leading to synergistic effects. Okay, that leads to, that is why these drugs are synergistic. So you can definitely get the question, amphotericin B and flucytosine are synergistic because, are antagonist because, which is the correct statement. So it is amphotericin B which increases the cell permeability and allows flucytosine to penetrate the cell. Now amphotericin B, what are the side effects with amphotericin B? What are the side effects with amphotericin B? Amphotericin B, most important, remember, it's your nephrotoxicity. That is the most common dose dependent side effect. That means higher the dose, higher the nephrotoxicity. Otherwise, overall, the most common side effect is your infusion reaction. That is your infusion reaction. Infusion reaction, it causes your chills and fever, right? It causes chills and fever. So yesterday in the study with me session that we have started, midnight, late night, you know, live study with me sessions. So Anisha remembers that chills karta hai, matlab shake hoga, fever karta hai, matlab high temperature bake hoga. So chills and fever is nothing but your, it is also called as shake and bake syndrome. So agar high five term karke pucha, which drug causes shake and bake syndrome? That is basically your chills and fever, infusion reaction, amphotericin B. Nephrotoxicity, most common dose dependent side effect. So what is the alternative to reduce the nephrotoxicity? What is the alternative to reduce the nephrotoxicity? We can give liposomal amphotericin B. We can give liposomal amphotericin B. So the advantage of liposomal is, it is decreased nephrotoxicity. Why? Because this has decreased tissue binding as compared to amphotericin. So even your renal binding is less, so nephrotoxicity is less. But spectrum mein koi farak nahi hai, and it is more costly. It is a more costly drug. So liposomal amphotericin B is your drug of choice for kala azar mein dete hain, right? PSM mein bhi aapne padha hai. Kala azar, liposomal amphotericin B is given. Now this amphotericin B, do we give oral, do we give parenteral, or we can give both oral and parenteral? How do we give amphotericin B? Is it given oral, parenteral, or both? Remember, it is not given oral, it is given IV. It can be given intrathecal as well. So most common side effect is infusion reaction. Most common dose dependent side effect is nephrotoxicity. रिमेंबर इट इज पैरेंटरल, यू कैन नॉट गिव इट ओरली. ओरली नहीं देते, इट इज ओनली इंजेक्शन. एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इज ओनली इंजेक्शन, ओरली नहीं दे सकते हैं. दैट इज द रीजन दैट इट इज रिजर्व ओनली फॉर सीवियर इन्फेक्शन, क्योंकि आई वी देना है, एडमिशन लगेगा, सो पेशेंट कैन नॉट टेक इट एट होम. सो इट इज रिजर्व फॉर योर सीवियर इन्फेक्शन ओनली. सो एम्फोटेरिसिन बी हो गया, इट कॉजेज योर नेफ्रोटॉक्सिसिटी, इट कैन इंड्यूस योर रीनल ट्यूबुलर एसिडोसिस. What type of renal tubular acidosis? Type 1, type 2, type 3, type 4. It is your type 1 RTA. So will you see hypokalemia or hyperkalemia? Amphotericin B causes nephrotoxicity with hypokalemia. Hyperkalemia is seen in type 4 RTA. Okay, it is seen in type 4 RTA. Now next one, what do we have to see next? Your azoles group, right? Azole group mein kya hai? So this is a table which tells you about the azoles from your reference book. So very important tables, whatever tables you have. Your pharmacologic properties of six systemic azole drugs. You have ketoconazole, itraconazole, fluconazole, voriconazole, posaconazole and isavuconazole. Okay, these all are your azole drugs, as the term says. All these are azoles. Now, water solubility, maybe we can skip it. Absorption, sabka high hai, iska variable hai. Most important, ek ye wala point yaad rakhna. Which has the maximum CSF to serum concentration ratio? Maximum serum to CSF concentration ratio is with voriconazole. If voriconazole is not in the option, then go for fluconazole. Okay, then go for fluconazole. So remember, it is your voriconazole more than your fluconazole basically for your CSF penetration, the CSF to serum concentration ratio. And which one, you can see the half-life, sabki half-life hai. Maximum aapki isavuconazole ki hai, minimum vori ki hai. Elimination, very important, you know, whenever you see tables, if you see that one is a separate, an exception with respect to the rest, all of you can see are this is hepatic elimination. Only one azole drug is your renal elimination. Very important point in your antifungals. Remember, it is your fluconazole. Okay, that's your fluconazole. So which is the drug which has your renal elimination, which is the azole drug? That is your fluconazole. Okay, that's your fluconazole. So again, to remember this, ki fluconazole, आपका सी एस एफ पेनिट्रेशन भी अच्छा है, इट हैज अ गुड सी एस एफ पेनिट्रेशन, बाकी का नहीं है. वॉरिकोनाजोल और फ्लूकोनाजोल का है एंड इट इज रीनल एलिमिनेशन. सो रिमेंबर फ्लूकोनाजोल, सो दैट इज योर लोअर एंड एंड द अपर एंड ऑफ द बॉडी. लोअर एंड इज बेसिकली योर किडनी, अपर एंड इज योर सी एन एस. यू कैन ऑल्सो रिमेंबर फ्लू इज लाइक फ्लो, सो इट गोज वाया द यूरिन फ्लो. ओके, इट गोज वाया द यूरिन फ्लो. So apply to questions in pharmacology come like fluconazole requires dose management in your hepatic dysfunction, true or false? It is false, kyunki hepatic se elimination nahi hai, renal se elimination hai. In this one, all of these can be given oral or IV. Ketoconazole is the one which is to be given only orally. So ketoconazole is oral only drug, it is not available as IV. Isko IV nahi de sakte hain, theek hai? So this is your important points in this table. Maximum CSF penetration vorico, if not in the option then fluconazole, and renal elimination fluconazole. Ketoconazole is oral only. Now voriconazole we have seen is the drug of choice for voriconazole. V ko ulta kar do aise, A ban jayega aapka. It is the drug of choice for aspergillosis, right? It's the drug of choice for aspergillosis. How about fluconazole? Where is your fluconazole used? So remember, yes, voriconazole is your aspergillosis. Fluconazole is not for aspergillosis ke against active nahi hai. Remember again alphabetically, ki C and F, they come close together. Fluconazole is for the 2C wala jo hai, and it is candida. And it is cryptococcus. Okay, it is candida and cryptococcus. In the maintenance phase, we use it once your amphotericin B has been given. कैंडिडा के लिए फ्लूकोनाजोल इज द ड्रग विच इज गिवन एज अ सिंगल ओरल डोज ट्रीटमेंट फॉर वल्वो वजाइनल कैंडिडियासिस. सो अगेन अ इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट, कौन सा सिंगल ओरल डोज देते हैं? फ्लूकोनाजोल. क्रिप्टोकोकस में मेंटेनेंस फेज में द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर योर क्रिप्टोकोकल मेनिनजाइटिस. व्हाट इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर क्रिप्टोकोकल मेनिनजाइटिस? नहीं, कॉक्सीडियोइडो अमित, कॉक्सीडियोइडो माइकोसिस, जो आपके डाइमॉर्फिक फंगाई है, कॉक्सीडियोइडो, हिस्टोप्लाज्मोसिस, स्पोरोट्रिक्स, ब्लास्टोमाइकोसिस, उनके लिए द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस जनरली इज आइट्राकोनाजोल. इट इज योर आइट्राकोनाजोल विच इज द ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस. ओके, ये है आपका कैंडिडा और क्रिप्टो, छोटे वाले फंगाई, बड़ा वाला नहीं. ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस फॉर क्रिप्टोकोकल मेनिनजाइटिस, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इज एम्फोटेरिसिन बी. एंड व्हाट डू वी गिव अलोंग विद एम्फोटेरिसिन बी? फ्लूसाइटोसिन. ओके, दैट्स योर फ्लूसाइटोसिन, नॉट फ्लूकोनाजोल, रिमेंबर दिस. एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इंक्रीजेस द परमियाबिलिटी ऑफ फ्लूसाइटोसिन, राइट? सो एम्फोटेरिसिन बी गिवन आईवी, फ्लूसाइटोसिन गिवन ओरली, ये देते हैं हम. दिस इज अबाउट योर दिस वन. एंड और क्या इसमें याद रखना है? दिस इज द टेबल फ्रॉम अनादर बुक फॉर योर अजोल ग्रुप अगेन. ओके, सो सबसे कम स्पेक्ट्रम ऑफ एक्टिविटी है फ्लूकोनाजोल की, वो सिर्फ क्रिप्टो और कैंडिडा के अगेंस्ट है, बाकी आपके दूसरे में है. पोसाकोनाजोल इज यूज इन म्यूकर माइकोसिस एज वेल. वी आर यूजिंग एम्फोटेरिसिन बी, राइट, इन द रिसेंट पोस्ट कोविड पेशेंट्स. रूट ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, इवन योर आइट्राकोनाजोल इज ओरल ओनली. ओके, इवन योर आइट्राकोनाजोल, सो इट इज योर आइट्राकोनाजोल एंड किटोकोनाजोल विच आर गिवन ओरली ओनली. सो रिमेंबर एक, दैट मीन्स इट इज एक रूट ओनली. ओके, सो दीज आर द ड्रग्स विच हैव ओनली वन रूट, दैट इज एक रूट ओनली, दैट इज इट्राकोनाजोल एंड किटोकोनाजोल. देन यू हैव ओरल बायो अवेलेबिलिटी, सबकी अच्छी दिख रही है, फ्लूकोनाजोल, आइसावोकिनाजोल सबका है. ड्रग्स लेवल्स अफेक्टेड बाय फूड और गैस्ट्रिक पीएच, मे बी वी कैन स्किप दिस. प्रोटीन बाइंडिंग स्किप कर दो. रूट ऑफ एलिमिनेशन, इसका रीनल है, बाकी सबका हिपैटिक है. ओके, बाकी सबका हिपैटिक है. फ्लूकोनाजोल फ्लो हो रहा है यूरिन में, फ्लूकोनाजोल, राइट. उसके बाद सीएसएफ पेनिट्रेशन, फ्लूकोनाजोल का है, आइसाव्यू का है, वोरिको का है, पोसोकोनाजोल का है. आइट्राकोनाजोल, रिमेंबर, डज नॉट एंटर द सीएनएस. सो यू कैन रिमेंबर आई एस आई, दैट मीन्स द आई. सो यू कैन रिमेंबर लाइक आइट्राकोनाजोल, इट स्टॉप्स एट द लेवल ऑफ आई, इट डज नॉट गो बियॉन्ड दैट. सो इट डज नॉट पेनिट्रेट द सीएनएस. ओके, इट डज नॉट पेनिट्रेट द सीएनएस. मैक्सिमम किसका है? वोरिकोनाजोल का. रीनल एक्सक्रीशन, फ्लूकोनाजोल का सबसे ज्यादा है. एंड बाकी आप मिस कर सकते हो. सो इन योर अजोल ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रग्स, बेसिकली द पॉइंट्स टू बी रिमेंबर्ड इन योर अजोल ग्रुप ऑफ ड्रग्स, विच आर द वंस विच आर गिवन ओरल ओनली. सो यू हैव एक रूट ओनली फॉर देम, आइट्राकोनाजोल एंड कीटोकोनाजोल. विच इज द ड्रग विच हैज योर रीनल एलिमिनेशन? रीनल एलिमिनेशन मीन्स यूरिन फ्लो. फ्लो मतलब फ्लूकोनाजोल. ओके, दैट्स योर फ्लूकोनाजोल. फ्लूकोनाजोल हैज द मिनिमम स्पेक्ट्रम, सीसी वाला, क्रिप्टो के मेंटेनेंस फेज में और कैंडिडा में सिंगल ओरल डोज रहता है. विच इज द वन विच हैज नो सीएनएस पेनिट्रेशन? विच हैज नो सीएनएस पेनिट्रेशन? रिमेंबर आइट्राकोनाजोल, इफ आस्क्ड डज इट हैव सीएनएस पेनिट्रेशन, इट डज नॉट हैव सीएनएस पेनिट्रेशन. ओके, इट डज नॉट हैव योर सीएनएस पेनिट्रेशन. Which has the maximum CNS concentration CSF में? That is वोरिकोनाजोल. And after that we have फ्लूकोनाजोल. Okay, after that we have फ्लूकोनाजोल. So these are the points to be remembered here. And very important point again, are azoles your fungicidal drugs or are they static drugs? Azoles are cidal or static? Azoles are cidal or static? These are your static drugs, right? What is the mechanism of action of azoles? They inhibit your ergosterol synthesis by inhibiting your 14D methylase enzyme. So, aapka SLE wala, jo yahan pe terbinafine aata hai, यहाँ पे आपके अजॉल आते हैं, दीज आर स्टैटिक ड्रग्स, राइट? दे आर बेसिकली इनहिबिटिंग द न्यू सेल फॉर्मेशन, दे आर नॉट किलिंग द सेल विच इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट. एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इज साइडर बिकॉज इट इज कॉजिंग द पोर्स एंड इट इज किलिंग द फंगस. योर दिस ड्रग विच इज ग्रिसियोफल्विन, लेट अस टॉक अबाउट ग्रिसियोफल्विन नाउ. सो फ्यू इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ऑन ग्रिसियोफल्विन, वॉट डू वी नीड टू रिमेंबर? ग्रीसियोफल्विन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स. ग्रीसियोफल्विन ग्रीस के जैसे मूव होता है स्पिंडल, इट इनहिबिट्स योर स्पिंडल, सो इनहिबिट्स योर सेल डिविजन. सो ग्रीसियोफल्विन इज ऑल्सो योर स्टैटिक ड्रग, राइट? इट्स नॉट साइडल, इट इज स्टैटिक. वट एल्स डू वी नीड टू रिमेंबर ग्रीसियोफल्विन? ग्रीस याद रखना फैट, सो द एब्जॉर्प्शन इंक्रीजेस विथ योर फैटी फूड. सो मिल्क वगैरह के साथ देने का, ग्रीस मतलब फैट के साथ देने का. इन योर ग्रीसियोफल्विन यू हैव एस यू एल एफ, राइट? इन अल्फाबेटिकली अल्फाबेट इफ यू सी एस एल एफ प्रेजेंट है, दिस कॉजेज योर डाइसल्फेराम रिएक्शन. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट कॉजेज योर डाइसल्फेराम रिएक्शन. And it's a static drug, ग्रीसियोफल्विन. Dermatophytosis में use करते हैं, but there are a lot of relapses which are seen. So now it is not used. Okay, now it is not used. That is about your ग्रीसियोफल्विन. Now next one, let us see the next one, echinocandins. Okay, echinocandins. What are the drugs that we saw in echinocandins? What is the mechanism of action? Remember echinocandins, they inhibit your beta glucan synthesis. ठीक है, वो beta glucan synthesis कर रहे हैं, inhibit कर रहे हैं. और क्या करते हैं? It is CAN. These drugs are active against candida. Okay, these drugs are active against candida. Along with candida, the drug which is used for aspergillus as well, when your other drugs have failed or as a combination therapy. Aspergillus is your caspofungin, ASP, aspergillus. So caspofungin is the drug which is used. These drugs require your loading dose except one drug. No loading dose is required in your mycafungin. Okay, no loading dose is required in mycafungin. An extra edge point in your antifungal drugs. Okay, that is the extra edge point. यह है echinocandins. What is the drug of choice generally for your nail infections? Fungal nail infections. That is terbinafine. Okay, that's the terbinafine. It has relatively short duration of therapy. It has affinity to your keratin rich areas, similar to greasyofulvin. So, आपका skin, nails, hair वहां पे जाएगा. So, terbinafine is the drug of choice for nail वाला. What is the mechanism of action of terbinafine? T ke baju mein S, it inhibits your squalene epoxidase, right? It inhibits your squalene epoxidase. It inhibits the squalene epoxidase, right? Uske baad, squalene to lanosterol, that is what it inhibits. Your ketoconazole, some important points about ketoconazole. Ketoconazole or the other azoles as well, almost all the azoles inhibit your cytochrome P. So they have a lot of drug interactions. Echinocandins do not have drug interactions. They are not metabolized by cytochrome P. So they have less drug interactions. Ketoconazole, keto and eto. Jaise humne etomidate padha tha recent anesthesia drugs mein. What is the side effect with etomidate? ADI को उल्टा पढ़ने के लिए बोला था हमने. ADI, it causes adrenal inhibition. Similarly, your ETO का भाई keto, ETO and keto, they cause your adrenal suppression. Okay, they cause your adrenal suppression and it is hepatotoxic as well. Okay, it is hepatotoxic as well. So ketoconazole is the one which is your which has a very high cytochrome P inhibitory action, right? It has a very high cytochrome P inhibitory action. Next wala, this we saw, mycafungin is the only echinocandin that does not require a loading dose. That is mycafungin. Okay, that is your mycafungin, which does not require the loading dose, right? ये वाला कौन सा है? इफ यू गेट अ इमेज लाइक दिस, स्क्वेलिन टू एर्गोस्टेरॉल, बीच में यू हैव लैनोस्टेरॉल, स्क्वेलिन एपॉक्सीडेज इनहिबिट करने वाला टर्बिनाफिन, उसके ही जो दूसरे ड्रग्स हैं फिनफिन वाले, ब्यूटेनाफिन, नेफ्टीफिन, टर्बिनाफिन. सो व्हेनेवर यू गेट अ क्वेश्चन ऑन मैकेनिज्म ऑफ एक्शन, ट्राई एंड राइम इट विद द ड्रग दैट यू ऑलरेडी नो. ओके, नाउ दिस इज द टेबल, द फाइनल टेबल दैट आई वॉन्ट टू रिवाइज विद ऑल ऑफ यू, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. And tomorrow we will see approximately like 20 or so MCQs in your antifungals. So I will get mixed bag questions, one-liners, clinical, flashcards on antifungals. Aaj ye topic revise kar lena. Tomorrow we will do the MCQs. Okay, we will revise with MCQs. So because I've told you that I personally very much believe in doing the MCQs as well when you are done with the topic, because that gives you an extra confidence and it tells you what type of questions can come in the exam. Alright, so table karte hai, that is for this session, MCQs hum kal karenge. Amphotericin B, okay, amphotericin B, mechanism of action, it binds to ergosterol in the cell membrane and forms the leaky pores. So we remember it with ampho forms the pores. This is a cidal drug. This is a cidal drug. Clinical applications, candida ke against bhi hai, aspergillus, blasto, crypto, histo, mucor. Mucor mein use karte hai, amphotericin hai jo hum use kar rahe hai. So this, it is reserved for serious infections because it is to be given only IV, oral nahi de sakte hai. So you have IV to be given for systemic infections. Liposomal forms are less nephrotoxic. Remember that we can use it topically also for ocular and bladder infections. We can use it topically for ocular and bladder infections as well. Toxicity, if the question is which is the dose limiting side effect, dose limiting, dose dependent, that is nephrotoxicity. So if you are giving it with any other drug which is nephrotoxic, then we have to very be careful. Infusion reactions are the most common side effect. Chills and fever, that is your shake and bake syndrome. Muscle spasms, hypotension ho sakta hai. This is amphotericin B. Azoles, keto, fluconazole, itra, posaconazole, varico and isavuconazole. All of these drugs inhibit your P450 dependent enzymes, the fungal P450 dependent enzymes, and they block the ergosterol synthesis. They are blocking your ergosterol. Resistance can occur with long term use. Look at the uses. Aspergillus, voriconazole, important. Blastomycosis, itraconazole, fluconazole, mucormycosis mein kaun sa azole de sakte hai? Remember, posaconazole. Otherwise, mucor mein hum amphotericin kar rahe hai. But specific, if question asks which azole used in mucormycosis, that is your posaconazole. These drugs can be used in candida and other infections. You have various topical and oral forms for dermatophytosis, oral parenteral forms for mycosis, ye sab hai. Most azoles undergo hepatic metabolism. Fluconazole eliminated in urine. This is very important. Flu, urine flow, urine mein jata hai. And fluconazole has a good CNS penetration, right? So it is used in fungal meningitis as well. Sabse zyada voriconazole ka, uske baad fluconazole ka. Ketoconazole is rarely used in systemic infections because it causes inhibition of your hepatic and adrenal P450. So hepatotoxicity bhi karta hai, adrenal suppression bhi karta hai, baki drugs ka levels increase karega by inhibiting P450. Other azoles are less toxic. Important point, voriconazole V4V causes visual disturbances and it's a class D risk in pregnancy. So like you remember in your anti-epileptic, which is the drug which causes visual field defects? Which is the drug which causes visual field defects? Very, very favorite question again. Now Jarvis, honestly, I don't know about that. Maybe I will check into it and let you know about posaconazole. Visual field defects, it's your vigabatrin, right? That is your vigabatrin. Similarly here, visual disturbances with voriconazole. So V4V, remember your voriconazole, vigabatrin. नेक्स्ट वन ए काइंड ऑफ कैंडेंस. कैंडेंस बीटा ग्लूकान सिंथेसिस इनहिबिट करेंगे तो सेल वॉल सिंथेसिस कम करेंगे. कैस्पो माइका एनिड्यूला फंगन. इकाइनोकैंडेंस दे हैव एक्टिविटी अगेंस्ट कैंडिडा. कैस्पो एएसपी यूज्ड एज अ सैल्वेज थेरेपी इन एस्परजिलस एज वेल. यू हैव आईवी फॉर्म्स. यू हैव इंपॉर्टेंट एक्स्ट्रा एच पॉइंट माइका फंगन. इट इंक्रीजेस द लेवल्स ऑफ निफेडिपिन एंड योर साइक्लोस्पोरिन. सो रिमेंबर डू नॉट गिव इट विथ निफेडिपिन या साइक्लोस्पोरिन के साथ, फिर उनका डोज कम कर देना. माइका फंगन इज द वन. एनिड्यूला हैज नो ड्रग इंटरैक्शंस. देन फ्लू साइटोसिन. साइटोसिन इनहिबिट्स डीएनए आरएनए पॉलीमरेज़. इट इज सिनर्जिस्टिक विथ एम्फोटेरिसिन बी. रिमेंबर विच ड्रग इज सिनर्जिस्टिक विथ एम्फोटेरिसिन बी. फ्लू साइटोसिन. साइटो जाता है साथ में. इट इज सिनर्जिस्टिक इन कैंडिडा एंड क्रिप्टो. एफ फॉर सी सी कैंडिडा एंड क्रिप्टो वेर इट इज सिनर्जिस्टिक विथ एम्फोटेरिसिन बी. फ्लू साइटोसिन इज गिवन ओरली. एम्फोटेरिसिन बी इज गिवन आई वी. सो इफ दे टेल यू क्रिप्टोकोकल मेनिनजाइटिस, oral amphotericin B, oral flucytosine, IV amphotericin B, IV flucytosine. Remember, IV amphotericin B and it is your oral flucytosine. Amphotericin B, intrathecal भी दे सकते हैं. And similar to your fluconazole, flu वाला जो drug देखा था, fluconazole, flows, renal elimination. Fluconazole and flucytosine, both of them have renal elimination. So remember, flow, urine flow has renal elimination. Similar to your anti-cancer drugs, aapka baki jo drugs hota hai, flucytosine, similar action, it can cause bone marrow suppression. It can cause bone marrow suppression. Terbinafen, naftifen inhibits squalene epoxidase. So squalene accumulates and it is toxic to fungi. Used in mucocutaneous infections, it has affinity to keratin. And it is, this drug can be given oral. Okay, this is the oral drug. GI upset or headache kar sakta hai. Drug of choice for dermatophytosis. Okay, that's the drug of choice for dermatophytosis. So that was, okay, so that was about your antifungal drugs. There are, you know, when we solve the MCQs tomorrow, a bit of twisted questions, one-liner questions, all of this we will be seeing tomorrow. This is very, very important. Maybe we'll see image-based questions as well. So please revise this topic today. And some of the important one-liners, mnemonics that I want you to remember. Ki amphotericin B, it is causing formation of pores. It is sidal drug. Amphotericin B ke saath synergistic drug, saath mein jane wala drug, is your flucytosine, not fluconazole. Flucytosine given orally. Which is the drug which causes disulfiram reaction? Sulfiram is your greasyofulvin. That is your greasyofulvin. Now, greasyofulvin, static or sidal? It is a static drug. Terbinafen, static drug. Azoles, static drug. Okay, all these are static. Amphotericin is your sidal drug. Okay, that's your sidal drug. Another one, which one causes your adrenal suppression? Eto and keto. So you have ketoconazole, which causes your adrenal suppression. Fluconazole. Fluconazole has activity against C and C. That is your candida and crypto. Candida and crypto, single oral dose in your vulvovaginal candidiasis. Aspergillus ke liye drug of choice is voriconazole, which is the echinocandin that can be used in aspergillus. That is your caspofungin. Okay, that is your caspofungin. Which drugs renal elimination? Your flu wala drugs, fluconazole and flucytosine, have renal elimination, right? They have your renal elimination. Azole drugs, which is the one which has maximum CNS penetration, CSF mein jata hai. Voriconazole and then you have fluconazole. Okay, voriconazole and then you have fluconazole. Azoles which are given only orally, no IV, ek hi route hai, itraconazole and ketoconazole. Okay, it is itraconazole and ketoconazole which have only oral. They can be given only orally. Amphotericin B cannot be given orally. Okay, amphotericin B cannot be given orally. Azole drug, which is used in mucormycosis, azole, that is your posaconazole. Okay, that's your posaconazole, which is used in mucormycosis. Drug for your generally all your major dimorphic fungi, be it coccidioidomycosis, histoplasmosis, blastomycosis, sporotrichosis, there we use your itraconazole, and it is used only orally. It does not have your CNS wala penetration nahi hai. It does not have CNS penetration. Agar CNS penetration hai, toh fir amphotericin B bhi dena padega. So, itraconazole, it stops at the eyes. Okay, does not have CSF penetration. So, this is about this session, guys. I hope all of you are now clear with antifungal drugs. Most important in antifungal, where you get the question, is your mechanism of action. Match the following aa sakta hai, image based dikha sakte hain, or direct pooch sakte hain. Any type of question can come on your antifungal. Mechanism of action is very, very important. Remember the new drugs as well, jo tRNA synthesis ko inhibit kar raha hai, which is causing, which one causes your Heifel distortion, jo another few new names that we saw. Heifel distortion todne wala tolnaftate, that is tolnaftate. How does your cyclopirox act? Cyclopyrimidine DNA pe act karta hai. This is used as a shampoo as well. If you see seborrheic dermatitis mein, cyclopirox is used as a shampoo in seborrheic dermatitis. So you have tolnaftate, you have cyclopirox, and you have the drug which inhibits your tRNA synthesis, that is protein synthesis. Jo aapka kaun sa wala drug tha, tavaborol kuch naam tha, kaun sa wala naam tha? So that was your tavaborol, right? Tavaborol inhibits your tRNA synthesis, tRNA. Alright, and so I hope this is easy. It is not as difficult as it seems. I think no topic is difficult. You know, if we try to make it, simplify it with mnemonics and with some concepts, any topic can be cracked like that. Hai na? So, tomorrow in the morning session, 12 p.m. And we will see the 12 p.m. tomorrow, we will see your antifungal drugs ke MCQs. So we will have MCQs on antifungal drugs tomorrow, right? Today 5 p.m. we have ophthal, squint, pupil and astigmatism if possible. And 10 p.m. we have sutures revision with PYQs and the knots, sutures and knots. This is the plan for today. Tomorrow antifungal MCQs and 10 o'clock, I'll let you know. All right. So thank you so much, everyone. Goodbye. Take care. Have a very productive day. And I'll see you at 12 a.m. also in the midnight for study with me session. So guys, I share the link of study with me sessions, which is like a live virtual library, on the Telegram group only. So you will not see it on the channel. You'll get the link only on the Telegram group. So you can join the Telegram group, Dr. Nikita's Rad Synapse, and I'll share the I'll share the link there for midnight study with me session. All right. Goodbye. Take care.